you scratch your Insta360 One X2 lenses, you might have a severe problem.
So I do apologize for the audio, it's absolutely terrible, and that's because for these type of videos I like to film and record all this stuff in the camera I'm sort of using or reviewing. In this case it's the Insta360 One X2. There was unfortunately someone doing like industrial gardening and had this massive blow and it's making a noise. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do voiceover. So I'm testing out this piece of kit. Now this piece of kit is a transparent lens guard for your One X2. The idea is it protects lenses from scratches and you can leave it on for filming. So what I'm doing today is I'm testing out if you can use this for filming in 360 and if you can use this for filming in the 180 mode. So let's have a look at the footage.
So I've now fitted the protective cap and I'm filming with it on the 180 mode and I'm filming towards me. Unfortunately there's someone blowing leaves around or blowing grass around really near where I'm filming, so you might be able to hear that. I'm recording on the Rode Wireless Go. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to switch the lens around and then I'm going to do some 360 filming, see if we see any stitching or any adverse effects of this protector. So now I'm filming on the selfie stick and still got the blower behind me and I've escaped so far. So I'm filming on the invisible selfie stick. Audio is being recorded within the Rode Wireless Go. I suspect I will be able to see some stitching problems from this protective lens in 360 mode, even if I reframe, simply because when I did my YouTube short about this, that was exactly what happened. So I did get stitching problems, but you've got to consider, is the Prodrocam lens cover something you want to use or do you want to risk it? Really got to consider the trade-off here between using a lens protector and getting the perfect image. And if you use a lens protector, you are going to get some image degradation.